Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Ekiman, and welcome back to the start of another RimWorld playthrough. So, a lot of people have been asking me to play this again, and it's had a recent update, so I thought I would jump back into this and play a few games of it again. There have been some new things added to the game, so I'm gonna have to relearn a little bit. Excuse me. So, let's get going straight away with this. We'll get a new colony going. And the first thing you can see is we've actually got some new AI storytellers. So we've got Chill Kali Classic, which is like a relaxed version of Cassandra, I believe. Yes. We've got Phoebe Friendly, which we had before. We've also got Randy Random now, which is just totally random gameplay events. And then we've got Tough Cleopatra Classic. But we're going to go with Cassandra Classic. So let's go with that. And as you can see here, we've got some new stats available on colonists. These actually don't do anything right now, but they're a hint of what's coming down the line. If you check out the official website, you can see more information on this stuff. So yeah, we're not actually too bothered about having points in any of these stats. So we're just going to hit random a few times. What we want is the lowest score we can get in these, which I believe is 3. We can actually get less than that, but it's quite rare. So, yeah, I'm just going to have a play around with the randomized feature here and get some colonists that I want, and then we will get right back to it. Okay, so I've got my colonists sorted now. Let's have a quick look at that. We've got Frederick Wheatles here. Reasonable stats across the board. Managed to get a 0 in cooking and 3s in the rest. We've got Henry Lawman here, or Henry Jensen, sorry, is that right? Yeah. And then we've got Chili here as well. So let's start this colony up, see how we do, what kind of a world we get. Do-do-do-do, the three of you. Yeah, we know about this bit anyway. So let's get going with this straight away. And this is one of the new things as well. Stockpiles have changed, so you can now actually specify things you want to put in them. Debris, resources, stuff like that. So we've got the same thing here as well. So you can set up multiple different ones for metals, and also we can now build launch pads, which we are going to need to sell things to traders. You can see there's some new artwork with the colonists. They've got their own unique, different sort of hairstyles now. There's been some changes made to it anyway. Money has been replaced with silver. I think that's right anyway. I don't think we used silver last time. So first things first, let's get all of these resources cleared for pickup. Those as well. Then we're going to have a quick look around the map and see where we want to set up. There we go. So we've actually got a decent spawn. Yeah, that'd be nice. We've got a thermal generator there. Lots of metals exposed. I guess we could set up here. Where have we got? Yeah, I guess we could set up here. This seems okay. So the first thing I want to do is do structure. Nope. Growing area. Where can we build? I guess we could put a couple in here. Let's put two growing areas in for starters. And then we're going to need to do ourselves a nutrient paste dispenser. Now these have changed as well. I am just going to put this here for now, but we might actually change this up. Actually, let's show you what we need. Yeah, we need these. Now we need hoppers. These will keep our food for the nutrient paste dispenser. That's a requirement now. So let's sort of speed this up a bit. Have them collect this stuff. We also want to designate some things for mining, so let's get all that. Let's just have a quick overview. I thought we had someone who was better at excuse me, it's social than that, but obviously not. So that will do us for now. So let's put these up. Actually, let's just get rid of all the plants there. Yeah, we will probably change this around though, because I want to have this indoors. So next thing I want to put in, may as well just let them keep building while we're doing this. Let's have a couple of solar generators down. Where are we going to put these? Let's just put three in there. And then let's run a power conduit straight into there. And we might also think about putting in some sun lamps. Actually. Whoa, cancel. Cancel that. Let's just put them like so. Nope. There we go. And also, we're going to need to run some power conduit to them. So let's do that. Let's do that. And that should keep all that going. And that way we're going to have our crops growing through the night as well. This is obviously just a basic setup right now. So the next thing we want to do is let's create ourselves some rooms. We're just going to go with smallish sized ones for now. And I might actually have these as our prisoner rooms. So let's put some doors in there. Furniture, we want a couple of beds. Let's put them on either side of the wall there. And let's put some lamps in as well. There we go. Yeah, I think that should do us. Did I just pause it? No. Okay. So we've got a source of food now. We've got some temporary beds. We might actually just... Actually, no, we'll use these for ourselves. So let's mine out that chunk there. And we're going to put in... Yeah, we'll have to wait till that's mined out, but we're going to put in another room here. And let's put in... Yep, a bed. Oops. Let's actually put it there. This is just temporary. I'm probably going to use this for prisoner storage. And let's just run some cable to there. So, we might actually start building... what do we want to get next? Yeah, they need to fill that in. We could do with some batteries, I guess. So, first things first, let's just sell these beds. We're not going to need those anymore. And actually, let's have them haul these rocks out of the way as well. Let's put some batteries in here for now. We can always take these out. We'll start with... We'll do four. So actually, we might just want to take that out. Yep. And let's put a wall around this so that it is safe from raiders. We want a way in though, so... Whoa, no. That's the point. We need our guys to be able to access the batteries. So let's just do that for now. Nope. Let's put a door in here. There we go. So we've got a very basic setup now. We've got some... Well, we will have some beds for them pretty soon. Fill that in there. Oh, poor Lawman. He's having to go off. And... Oh, he hasn't got a bed, has he? That could be a problem. So let's just put my temporary bed down. I should not have sold bed so quick, I guess. There we go. Let's have him. Can we not prioritize construction anymore? Lawman, let's take him off mining then and see if he will build that bed. Nope, he's not gonna. Okay, so we'll cancel that then. Lawman's gonna have to wait then. We'll put him back on mining for now. So let's mine out this space here because we could always do with some more batteries. Got some food built up already. Just need him to work on this bit now. Yeah, no, we need colonist beds. We'll get to it. And looks like we've uncovered some minerals as well there. Oh, we've got lots of guns as well. So let's find out who is our best shooter. Shooting 5, 3, and 8. So we'll give you the Lee Enfield. Chili, you can have this pistol. And Weetle, you can have this pistol. This is one of the changes as well because obviously we used to only start out with one gun between us. So that's pretty cool. Right, so we just need them to finish construction of this and then we're going to start storing power up. Finish these walls off. There we go. And we probably will start digging into here actually. But I'm thinking we might actually just surround this area. Maybe we will do a wall. We want to leave that open for some expansion. So let's just have a look how much space we need. We need somewhere for them to walk between. Let's actually just put that down so we've got a placeholder. And we're going to run a wall along here. I'm going to start building up our defenses already. What's this one? All right, we've got an eclipse going. That's fine. That is fine. Let's just right click that to dismiss it. Probably going to bring this wall down here and then across here. And start maybe digging into the rock a bit. I know last time we had our base out in the open, but I think we're going to change that around this time. Alright, Lawman's finally got himself a bed. And these guys are finishing off construction. There we go. We should be getting some... Oh no, we won't be getting any power. That's fine. And... let's have them haul these two things away. Actually, they can haul that away as well. In fact, let's have them haul away anything in this area. We don't want any of that stuff. And they can also cut a bunch of plants down as well. Let's get that sorted. Solar flare has begun. Right, well, it doesn't matter anyway. We were in eclipse, so we couldn't actually do anything. Get rid of that stuff. Let's cut all this grass. Let's just speed this up fully. I want to get them to finish work on doing this. How are we doing for minerals? Not too bad. Let's start marking up some of this stuff as well. Yeah, so we briefly talked about stockpiles earlier. We're going to get into that later on. But it's now actually required. You can't just mine metals and have them go into your supply here. You actually need somewhere to physically store them before you can use them. Which is pretty cool. Maybe I shouldn't have marked all these plants for clearing, but it's no real biggie. So yeah, they're going to have to mine this metal before they can work on the construction. That's fine, we're doing alright for food. Not a lot else we can really do right now. Local squirrel has gone mad, so I should have checked to see where that guy was, but he will show up, no doubt. There we go. And they've taken him down. That's cool. So we'll have that available for hauling. Maybe we will move our stockpiles. But not right now. Do we need to join these up? Well, we do right now, so let's just do that. Starvation, really? They've got food. Oh, it doesn't have power. Because we're in a solar flare. Alright guys, well, you're just going to have to live with it for a little while, I'm afraid. No trading capacity. We need to get that sorted pretty soon. But I'm not too worried about it right now. Actually, we will put that... comms console. We will put that there for now. We can always sell it and rebuild it somewhere else once we've got things sorted. Great, so our batteries are now filling up. They can eat. Everything is looking good. So, we need to start thinking about putting more of a wall around here. So, we'll put that to there. We're actually going to put a door in here. And, yeah, maybe we'll have one somewhere else as well. But for now, we'll just leave it like that. So, let's bring this down to here. And, yeah, maybe we'll change where our stockpile is as well. Or one of our stockpiles. Where do we want to put that? Can we just build a wall straight across a stockpile? Probably not. Tell you what, let's just for now, let's grab those as well. Let's put a door in here. And we will take our wall down there. Okay, so we've at least got some kind of defenses, although it's not much. We really need to start thinking about getting some turrets in place. But we can do that once... Crashville, no. We're going to go back and rename it Hadley's Hope in homage to our first colony. I should have called it Hadley's Hope Mark II. Trade ship is passing nearby, then a combat supplier. Yeah, I need to... you won't be able to see it, guys, but I've actually got fraps covering up my silver amount. So it's hard for me to know how much cash I've got. And let's have Lawman open communications and see what these guys have. Shells fired from cannons, cool. And missiles as well, so we're going to be getting missile launches at some point. No one to sell. Yeah, we could buy ourselves some weapons, but I don't really think we're going to need them at this point in the game. I might regret that soon enough, though. So, let's... How are we doing? Walls getting constructed, that's fine. Raiders have landed nearby, and we've just got the one... Tynan. That's a coincidence. So hopefully these guys will finish off construction of the wall before that, before the raid starts. Didn't I put a door in? I hope they're going to haul that away. Anyway. Alright, yes, there was... He was constructing the door. There was no need to do that. Okay. That's fine. So... Are these batteries all sharing power? Yes, I think they are. Maybe we can put another couple in here. And we also want to think about a research table as well. Raiders are finished staging and are beginning their attack. That is fine. We can deal with that in a second. Let's... where are we going to put equipment racks? Well, for now, let's put them along this wall. There we go. Research bench. How much space do we need for this? We may as well just chuck this... It's all a bit haphazard, this one. Right there for now. That's fine. And then we can get some research going as well. Where's our raider? Tynan is making his way inside. So let's just recruit our guys, move outside, and... let him into our house, apparently. So he really shouldn't provide too much of a challenge to us at this point. Hopefully, anyway. Yeah, okay. Is he dead or is he wounded? He's incapacitated. So we're going to check Weetles and Chili off duty. We're going to have Lawman. Okay. That's going to be a problem. I should have built an extra bed. Let's just unassign that. We'll have him be captured. And let's allow that for purchase. And then I guess what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to put in 1, 2, 3. We're going to do it there, I guess. So let's put an extra room in so Lawman's got somewhere to sleep. And we'll do it like that. And a door right there. And... oops, wrong key. Let's put his bed there. And a standing lamp here. Right, so... these guys will go about the business again. Let's actually just cancel the two batteries and then hopefully, yeah, they'll start building that and Lawman will have somewhere to sleep. And before we finish this episode up, let's select Tynan. And we want to recruit the guy and we want friendly chat. But yeah, I think I'm going to call this the end of the episode. I think we've made some good progress in our first episode. A lot more than we did in the first episode of the last run. I've got a bit more sort of knowledge of what I'm doing now. So yeah, I'm going to call this the end of the episode, guys. I hope you are pleased that RimWorld is back. We're going to keep this going as long as we can. And I don't know, maybe we will... I'm not sure how we're going to expand this yet. I've just sort of thrown this together as a quick base. But I'm assuming we're going to keep building into the rock here. And then we're going to need to be putting down turrets around here. And we'll probably try and get a geothermal generator down here and run a cable up to our base. So yeah, that's the plan. But yeah, as I said, I'm going to end the episode here, guys. I hope you've enjoyed watching this. I'm out for now and I will see you soon for some more RimWorld. Peace.